Ta'ala. Thereafter, there is the story of Salih alayhi salatu wasalam. He was sent to a nation known as Thamud. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of some very important issues here. Do you know that when there is a bright and intelligent youngster, very bright, very intelligent, what do the family members say? Normally they say, hey, send this youngster to the university, let him become a doctor, he's very clever. Let him become a lawyer, an accountant. We are not saying it's wrong to become lawyers and accountants and doctors. But if that youngster then decides, no, I want to become a maulana, I want to become a sheikh, I want to become an alim, sometimes members of his or her own family will say, you know what, there's no future for you. No future at all. What are you going to earn? These people earn 500 rands a month and they go around begging, they drive the Corollas and the Datsuns 120Ys and so on. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. If that is our understanding of happiness and goodness, then we are also going to be destroyed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not do that to us. So that is what the people of Salih told him. He was very bright, very intelligent. Do you know what they said? After he became a messenger and he told them the goodness, he says, I am a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I've come to you with good news. They said, Ya Salih, قد كنت فينا مرجوا قبل هذا. O Salih, we had lots of hope in you. We thought you were going to achieve something, you were going to become someone in society and community before you came to tell us that now I'm a prophet. Allahu Akbar. So they lost hope. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in fact made him far higher than everyone else. So the same applies to the ulama of this ummah. A point of encouragement for those who are intending to study this deen. There is a chance and a possibility that Allah can bring together for you both the deen and the dunya. There can be a doctor who is also a sheikh. We can have an accountant who is a very good Muslim. As I said yesterday, we are in need of the Muslim doctor, the Muslim accountant, the Muslim lawyer, even the Muslim plumber, who knows about Islam and who is a brilliant person. May Allah grant us success in both scopes, inshallah.